ਆਉਂਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਘਰ ਵਾਲੀ ਨੂੰ ਗੱਲ ਕਰੇ ਤੇ ਚੈਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਸੀ। ਅੱਜ ਵੀ ਅੱਜ ਕੁਦਰਤੀ ਹਾਲਾਤ ਬਦਲ ਗਏ ਆ ਕਿ ਅੱਜ ਅਖਬਾਰ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਅਮਰੀਕਾ ਚਲੇ ਜਾਓ ਅਖਬਾਰ ਸਵੇਰੇ ਛਪ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਸ਼ਾਮ ਨੂੰ ਨੈਟ ਤੇ ਪੜ ਲਿਆ। ਸੋਸ਼ਲ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਹੈਜ਼ ਚੇਂਜ ਦ ਟੋਟਲ ਡਾਇਨਾਮਿਕਸ ਆਫ ਦ ਗੇਮ। ਪ੍ਰਿੰਟ ਮੀਡੀਆ, ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਓਨਲੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਪ੍ਰਿੰਟ ਮੀਡੀਆ, ਟੂਡੇ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ 800 ਚੈਨਲਸ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਵਾਜ਼ ਲੁਕਿੰਗ ਐਟ ਦ ਨੰਬਰਸ ਦ ਰਜਿਸਟਰਡ ਨਿਊਜ਼ ਪੇਪਰਸ ਇਨ 1780 ਇਫ ਆਈ ਰਿਮੈਂਬਰ ਕਰੈਕਟਲੀ ਦ ਬੰਗਾਲ ਗੈਜ਼ਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਦ ਫਸਟ newspaper, and today there are more than a lakh of newspapers. So you have to see the changing dynamics, you have to see the number of journalists that have exploded in this world with the exploding of economy, but you have, with that changing of times, positives have come in and negatives have also come in. If I can tell you about a story of covering Kargil, I also talk about a stag story where other incidents which were not so good to be reported about are being reported about. I also share an incident with you where Punjab government faced a very challenging task. A saint was shot at, was murdered in Vienna, and the repercussions we had to face here, why? Because everything was so active on social media. Before you could say Jack Robinson, there were riots that had taken place literally here. So things have really changed, and we need to equip ourselves to be able to fight those changing of times. And I do assure you, whether it's the housing policy, I think you've taken it up with my minister who was here, Mr. Daljeet Chima and Mr. Maluka, who were here yesterday, and they are going to take it up with the chief minister. But I assure you one thing, Jammu ji, jai mainu housing mehkma dwa de te sweri de dunga ghar jinne dohun, magar if you can go that extra mile, then I will also take those two extra steps. Nahi ta main safari zarur thodi leke jaunga ki Jammu ji ne gharan di gal kiti si, magar mere hath ta kalla travel wala kam si, tusi mere kol ik kari aaye, and I have signed that file and come to you because I wanted to say it on the stage that whatever you came to me for increasing the allowances, I've already done that. Some other issues that you did talk about, this Dinanagar incident. Actually, I didn't want to talk about it here, but I'm happy that you did bring it up. Sir, I would want you to get to the bottom of it. You know what happened? It's been misunderstood and misinterpreted that the government has something to do with it. It is a person who fought for the nation. It was a nation's war on terror. We all fought very unitedly and very strongly. A person was lauded for his heroics one day before, and the next day he was condemned that he fired, he never received any bullet injuries. They were all, either he did it himself, they were self-inflicted, or there was no bullet injury. Whereas there is no report with the government to say that there have been self-inflicted wounds. And the girl of that child, the girl of that inspector cried, because first day when she went to school, she was picked up on her, people picked her up, and she was brought in the middle of the school and honored that your father has fought for this country of ours. And the next day that girl was made fun of, that your father has not been true to this country of ours. And it was a sad thing, and out of that reaction that thing has happened. But we will be happy to sit and correct it. But I would also request you that some issues, because it was a terrorist attack, and if there is no report, either give me a report which says that this happened, there were self-inflicted wounds. But if there weren't, I guess journalists also have to be very responsible in what they're reporting, because their one line here or there can ruin a lot of things. He's been kind enough that he talked about cases filed by certain individuals. You won't believe it that no politician wants to file a case against a journalist, because we feel it's a relationship. I spend more time with the journalist than I spend with my wife, because I'm all the day out in the field. And it's a relationship that one values, because one